Hello everyone. So today we will discuss how to write a program to add to 16-bit number. So now I'll take an example. I'll take two numbers as. So first number I'll consider it as 1, 2, 3, 4. This is an hexadecimal number, so I'll consider the suffix as H. Second number, I'll take it as F567. So now, I perform a manual addition. So 7 plus 4 means it is 11. 11 means in hexadecimal, we can write it as B. Then 6 plus 3 is 9, so 5 plus 2, 7, F plus 1 is 10, so the result is 1079BH. So now first we'll see how to store this number, then how to fetch the numbers using an 8051 instruction, after that how to perform addition and how to store the result. So now if I consider the 8051 memory location, so now I'll take the first number. So first number is a 16-bit number. So 16-bit number means we have 2 bytes over here. So we have 2 bytes. So now if we want to store 2 bytes means we require 2 locations. So we require 2 locations to store this number. Similarly, second number also is a 16-bit number, or it is of 2 bytes, or you can say that it requires 2 locations. Okay. So now on adding these two numbers, 16-bit number plus 16-bit number, we get the result as in 17-bit. Or 17-bit means I can say that it is 3 bytes. So it is a 3-byte number. So 3 bytes means we require 3 locations. So now first we'll see how to store this number. So while storing this number, what I'll do, first I'll consider the lower byte will be stored first, then the higher byte will be stored. Similarly, even in the result also we can store the lower byte, or here if there are 3 bytes, so I'll store the first byte, second byte and third byte. So now here I can take So this is the first byte, so that is 9B. So 9B is the first byte. Similarly, 07 is the second byte, and the third byte is 01. So I'll call this one as first byte. This is the second byte. And this is the third byte. So now coming to the memory location. So I'll take these two locations to store the first number. Similarly, two more locations to store the second number. First number and this is the second number. Similarly, I require 3 memory locations to store the result. So I'll take the memory location somewhere around here. Right. So here we'll be storing the result. So here what I'll do, I'll store the first byte. So here I'll be storing the second byte. Here I'll be storing the third byte. So I'll be storing the third byte, right? So now I'll take the first number. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4. So first 3, 4 will be stored, then 1, 2 will be stored. Similarly, second number 61, sorry, it is 67. Then F5 will be stored. Similarly, result, first I should store the logo first byte result, that is 9B. Next I should store the second byte, that is 07. Next I should store the carry, that is 01. Right, so this is single bit number. Right, so I have inserted 7 zeros in order to make a byte, and that is 01. Now we'll see what will be the address of this one. So I can store it into any location. So here what I have done, I have started storing from the first location. So this address is 00H. It's an hexadecimal address. Right. Similarly, I'll take this one as 01, so this is 02, and this is 03. Similarly, I'll be storing the result at some other different location. Say I'll take this one as 40H. Similarly, this is 41H, and this is 42. So now we know that so memory locations are divided into register bank. That is, such first few addresses divided as in register bank, bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, and bank 3. In that, in each bank you have totally 8 registers, so starting from R0 to R7. So now this is nothing but R0. Similarly, this is R1, this is R2, and this is R3. So memory address of the register R2 of bank 0 is 2, or R0 of bank 0 is 00, or R1 of bank 0 is 01. So that means I can say that I have stored 34 in register R0, or 12 in register R1, or 67 in register R2, or F5 in R3. Right. So now we have defined the numbers, we have added it, and we have seen how to store this one in the memory location. So now we'll see what is the logic behind this addition. Or I can say, we'll see first what operation I have to perform over here. Right. So now I want to define this number, or I want to store this number into the memory location. Right. So from the memory location, I have to take that one into a register R0, R1, R2, and R3. Right. So now I can say that, so first I'm copying this number into the registers R0 and R2, right? So now I can directly say that copy first number. So to where we are copying the first number, we are copying it into R1 and R0. Copy the first number into R1 and R0. That means, so this is stored in R0. So this number is stored in R1. So this number is stored into R2, and this byte is stored into R3. So now we have copied the first number into R1 and R9. Similarly, what is the next step? So I have to copy the second number. Copy second number. Copy second number to which register? It is R2 and R3. So I'll write R3 first and R2. And that means this is your most significant digit or bits. This is the lower significant bit. So now you have copied this one. After that, if I want to perform the addition, I can perform only an 8-bit addition over here because size of the microcontroller is 8-bit, right? So now what I'll do, I'll perform the lower bit addition. So now add lower bit number. So the next logic is I have to add lower bits. Lower bits. Right, so where is that lower bit? It is in R0 and R2. Right, so now after adding this one, I'll be getting the result, that is 9B. It is the first byte, where I have to store the first byte into 40H. Right, so now store lower result. Lower result. And where we are storing this one? Into 40H. Got the result, I should store this one into 40H. Similarly, next what I have to do, I have to add the higher bytes. Add higher bytes. Higher bytes. And where are they? It is in R1 and R3. So directly I write it as R1 plus R3. Right. So now whenever we perform the higher addition, or this is the second addition, so we have to see what is the carry from the previous addition. If there is a carry, that should be added for the second addition. So now here, I am adding the higher bytes. Along with this one, I have to consider the previous carry. Similarly, after this, I have to store the higher byte result. Store higher result. And where this result is stored, so higher result will get, in this case is 07, it is the second byte, and second byte is stored at 41H. So I'll write this one as 41H. So we are storing the result into 41H. Similarly, once again, from this addition, we might get a carry. If there is a carry, that is treated as a third byte, and that is stored into 42H. So directly I'll write it as store carry, and where we are storing this one, this is stored into 42H. So now we have seen how to add, and we have seen how what is the logic behind this one, what operation should be done first and what operation should be done next. Now we'll try to relate this one to the 8051 instruction, that is how to perform this operation. Right. So now here there are two add instruction. So if I take the first add instruction, so this is with the lower byte. Right. So directly to perform this addition, we'll be using add instruction. Similarly for the second one, so here we are adding higher byte along with this the previous carry. So this is done using add carry instruction. So that is ADDC, add with carry. Similarly, if you are copying the numbers or if you are storing the result, and all this operation will be done using move instruction. Similarly, even the storing of the result is also done using move instruction. So now we'll see what is the instruction we have to use over here. So if I take this one, if I take the first one, so copy first number into R1 or R0, right? So what is this? This is 34 or 2Y. So if I take this one, we are storing the result into 40H, right? So now here, whatever the number we are using in the first case, and this is the data, but here, whatever the number we are using over here, so this is an address. So whenever we specify this one, data or address in an instruction, right? So either I can specify the data in the instruction, or I can specify the address in the instruction. Right. So there is a difference in specifying these numbers in an instruction. So now I'll take a move instruction. I'll write move a comma 12H. Right. So now I want to copy the data into an accumulator register. So directly I can write, cannot write 12. So I should specify it as hash 12. Right. So that is, so we have a memory location. Right. Say I'll take this as the memory location, and address of this memory location is 12H. So now inside this memory location I have 25. Right. So now whenever I write this instruction move a comma 12H, so now once I execute this instruction, so I'll be having a equal to 12. Because this is an immediate number, this we are copying into accumulator. Similarly, if I write the instruction in this way, so that is move a comma 12H. So now this operand becomes an address. So now in 12H, what is the data we have? We have 25. So 25 will be copied into accumulator. So a equal to 25. So now in the first instruction we have specified data at the source operand position, and in second instruction we have specified address in the source operand position. Exactly. So this difference we should be knowing whenever we write an 8051 instruction, whether we are considering the data in the instruction or whether we are considering an address. We are specifying address or data in the instruction and how to represent that one in an instruction. So now here we are specifying the data in the instruction. Here we are specifying an address in an instruction. Right. So this is the logic behind how to add to 16-bit number. Right. So now we'll see how to write a program 8051 instruction. So first we'll see how to open this project. Directly right click on project. Click on the project. So first click on the project, then new project. Right. So now either you can create a new folder or store your project into a new folder, or anywhere in your drive you can store this project. So now I've created one folder, that is my controller program. Inside that one I'll be storing this one. So I've given the project name as program, save. So once the project name is given, it will ask for the target, that is which microcontroller you will be using. So there are many manufacturers of our microcontroller. So those names are available over here, whether it is an Acer Lab or whether it is an Analog Devices or Atmel. Similarly, if I see over here whether it is a Texas Instrumentation microcontroller, or even we have Philips microcontroller or a Samsung microcontroller. So we have to select which type of microcontroller we are using. Right. So now here I'll select an Atmel microcontroller. In that, so there are many devices. So I'll be using 89C51 89C51 1ED2 microcontroller. So this is an 8-bit microcontroller, and that description is given over here. So I'll select this one, OK. So it will ask whether to copy the standard 8051 setup code to the project folder. Right. So now, whenever this window is pop up, click on No. By mistake, if you have clicked on Yes, later you can remove that one from the file. Right. I'll click on No. So now whenever I click on the No, I'll be just getting one source group folder over here. If you click S over there, you'll be having one file over here. Right. So now I don't want that one, so I clicked on No. So now I want to write the program. So in order to write a program, we have to open an editor file or a text file. To open the text file, just directly go to File, click on File, New. Or shortcut, here we have that icon. You can click on this one. So the new file will be opened over here. You can type the program for you. So I'll just open the previous one. So now I've given the file name as 16-bit edition. So how to give the file name? So just click over here, save. So I've created one file. So now here what I'll do, first I'll type few statements. Say I'll type move a comma 12h. Right. So now I want to save this one. So click on save icon. So now it will open your folder where exactly you have stored your project. Right. So now here you have to give the file name. So I'm performing an addition. So I'll write it as addition, and this is a 16-bit. So I'll write it as addition 16-bit. And always you should have a file extension as ASM. So it is addition 16-bit.ASM. Now click on save. So whenever you have saved your file, so that file will not be added to your source group. You have to add that one. So right click on source group, add files to source group. So now by default that folder will be opened where you have saved your project. Now just change the file type. It is an ASM file. You have given it as .asm. So now I have given the name as addition 16-bit. So now what happened? So the file has been added here, addition 16-bit.asm. Right. So now we have to write an instruction. Right. So first I'll just write one comment over here. What is this program? So here addition of 8051 ASM to add to 16-bit number to 16-bit numbers. So now if I observe over here, so I have put the semicolon, then I have written some statement. So whatever the statement yields right after the semicolon, that is treated as a comment. So this will not be considered for the execution. Right. So now this is an assembly language program to add to 16-bit number. Right. So now first, what is the logic here? We have to define two numbers, and that number should be stored into register R1 and R0. So in R0, I have to store 34. Right. So now directly I'll write it as move R0 comma hash 34. Right, because this is the number now. So this is the data. How to write the data? Using hash. Hash the number. Next we have to write the number. So now here the first number is 34 and that should be stored into R0. So I'll write it as hash 34. Move R0 comma hash 34. Right. So now here also I can write a comment. So what operation I'm performing over here? I'm copying the number. So I can write it as copy. What number we are storing? We are storing the lower byte. Right. Copy lower byte of, this is the first number. So directly I can write it as copy lower byte of first number. Right, so where we are copying? We are copying it into R0. Right. So next I should copy the higher byte. Right. So I can write just move and that is copied to R1 hash, what is the number? It is 12. I can write it as 12. Right. So now whenever you write this number, right, so which type of addition we are performing here? We are adding two hexadecimal number, right? So we should write that as 34H or 12H. If you don't write this H over here, then this number is treated as a decimal number and in the memory location it is stored as a hexadecimal. So 12 will be converted into hexadecimal, that becomes, so 10 is A, 11 is B, and 12 is C. So C will be stored into memory location. Right. So now here I've copied the first number into R0 and R1. So now here also I can write a comment. So it is higher byte. So copy higher byte of first number. Right. So now we have copied the first number. Next, I should copy the second number. Right. So where we are copying R1 and R3. Sorry, it is R2 and R3. So now, first should be in R2 and next one should be in R3. What is that number? It is F567. So now, 6-7 over here and it is here 5. Right, so now just observe over here. So whenever I have typed the numbers in the first instruction, second or third, so that was displayed in purple color. So now it is in black color. That means it is not treating this as a number. It is treating this as a variable name. Right. So now we have to tell to the microcontroller that FY is also a number. So what we have to do, we have to insert 0 over here. Right. So now this is not considered as a digit. So this is used to tell the microcontroller that, so whatever the number we have taken over here, so it has an alphabet or hexadecimal character F at the first position. Right. So now, whenever I insert this 0 over here, it is treated as an 8-bit number and that 8-bit number is F So now here we are copying the number into register R2 and R3. And what is this number? It is the second number. So I'll write the command as copy lower byte of second number and copy lower byte of second number. Right. So now we have copied the number. Next, what we have to do? So copy first number, copy second number, add lower bytes. Right. So where is the lower byte? It is in R0 and R2. So now I have to add it. Right. So I'll write it as add lower byte is R0, comma, another one is R2. So add R0, comma, R2. So this is the operation I have to perform here. I have to add 34 and 67. Where is 34 R0 and where is 67? It is in R2. So I am adding this one, adding R0 plus R2. So I can write an instruction, add R0 and R2. So now whenever we are performing an arithmetic operation, so one operand should be in accumulator register. So I cannot write both registers over here. So your destination should be an accumulator register. So here what I have to do, first I have to copy that content to accumulator, move A, R0, right. So first number is there in accumulator, so now I can use this one, add A, R2. So I am adding the second number to the first number, right. So after adding, what I have to do, I have to store that one. To store, once again I will be using move instruction. Where I have to store, so first byte it should be stored to 40H, right. So now I can write this one as move hash, so it is an address, so we should not write hash, so I can write it as move 40H comma here, right. So now here also we can write a comment, what should be the comment here, I'm storing to lower byte. So here what we have done, here we have added, so what is that addition, so add lower byte, lower byte. So I have added lower byte and I have stored the lower byte. So now what I have to do, I have to perform the second addition, right. So similarly, where is the second number? It is in R1 and R3. We have to add this one. So I should copy one number to accumulator. I'll copy R1 to accumulator. So I can write it as move A, R1. Then I'm adding R1 with R3. So add A is R1 with R3. After adding, I have to store the result. But here, it is a higher byte addition, so what we have to add? R1 plus R3 plus previous carry. So if you are considering the previous carry, so the instruction should be add C. So I'll change this one to add C. Right. So move A, R1, add C, A, R3. After that, you are storing the result and that should be stored into which location? It is stored into second byte, so 41H. So move 41H comma A. So you are storing the higher byte. So now what instruction I can write? Add higher byte and store so here. It is actually the second byte, right? So I'll write in this way, second, store second byte, or here I'll write it as store first byte. So now I've stored the second byte. Next, what I have to store? I have to store the carry. So where is the carry now? It is in the carry flag. If there is a carry from this instruction or this addition, so that carry flag bit will be set. So now I have to store the carry flag. Right. So to store this carry flag, what I'll do, I'll write one instruction, that is ABDC 8, #00H. Right. So now what we are doing means ADC means it is adding two operand. And what are those operand? It is A and 00H. A plus 0 means we will get 0 only. Right. But here there is a carry flag. So carry flag will be added to this instruction. Or I can just write this one as so now what I am adding, I am adding accumulator contain plus 00 plus carry. So now if accumulator is 0, so that is if A value is 0, if A equal to 0 means, and what is this? So this becomes now 0 plus 0 plus carry. Right. So what will be the result of this one? So this result will be equal to carry. Right. So this result will be equal to carry. Right. If carry is 0, this becomes 0. If carry is 1, this becomes 1. So to perform this operation, so we have written the instruction in this way. So I have to add this one. So for that purpose, ADC A, 00H. But before writing this one, we should ensure that accumulator is 0. So for that one, I will write it as move A, #00H. That means I'm transferring 0 to accumulator. So now I'm adding the content of A with the accumulator. So finally I have to store this one. I'll write it as move. To which location we have to store? It should be stored to 42H. Move 42H, A. Then finally terminate the program. So to terminate the program, we'll write an assembler directive, that is end. Right. So now how can I write a comment here? What we are doing, I'm storing the carry. Store carry. Or directly I can write this one as, this is the third byte. So I can write it as store second byte, or over here we are storing the third byte. Exactly. So once again, so after writing the program, store this one. So save this one, click on the save icon, or directly go to file and save. Or shortcut Control S. So I'll save this one. Right. So now I have to see whether there are errors in the instruction or the whatever the instruction we have written. So whether there is an error. To check that error, so I have to build the file. So here we have build target. Click on this build target, or next rebuild target. So once I click on this one, so here in the output window, so this is an output window, so here we'll be getting the error message. So now in this case there are zero error. Right. So first it will display the folder, that project folder. What is that? We have given the project name as program. So it has built this target, that is file is edition 16-bit.asm. Right, and there are no errors over here. So now what I'll do, I'll try to introduce an error. Just I'll remove this semicolon here. I'll save it, I'll click on build target. So now what happens, it will display the message saying that target not created. Right, so if there are no errors, then target is created. If there is an error, there is the target will not be created. It will display the line number also. Right. So that is in this file edition 16-bit.asm at line number 10 there is a syntax error. So now just go to that line number 10. What is that line number 10? Add A, R0. Whenever we write the operands, so source and destination operand, it should be separated with a comma. So previously I had removed that comma. Now I'll introduce that one. Once again, save it, build. So now what happened? So building is successful. So with zero errors. So always, whenever you type a program, if there are errors, debug the first error. So because due to first error or the first error, you might get n number of errors. So after debugging two errors or one error, then once again build the target. Exactly. So then see if there are errors, then debug that errors, and once the errors is clear, then only you can simulate this one. Right. So now I'll debug this one. So just go to this icon debug, click on start or stop debug session. So whenever I open this one, so here you'll be getting a workspace. So this workspace will display the registers, all the registers of your 8051. So now here, R0, register R0, R1, R2, R3, R4, 5, 6 and 7. And what is the initial value? Initial value is 0. So now similarly here, what is the B register? Accumulator 0, B register 0. Similarly, is a stack pointer. So stack pointer has started from 7, or instruction pointer is 7. So that is the first address where we will be fetching a next instruction. Yeah. Then we have data pointer. Data pointer is equal to 0. Then finally program status 4. So here we have that flag register. So auxiliary carry. Or carry, AC means auxiliary carry, initial value is 0, or CY means initial value is 0, overflow is 0, parity is 0, right? So whenever we execute the instruction, whenever we execute an arithmetic instruction, the flag register or the program status word will change depending upon the result of that particular instruction, right? So now I want to execute the instruction, right? So now I have taken the first instruction as move R0, 34. So 34 will be copied to R0. At the same time, this value will be there in the memory location also. And what is that memory location? So it is 00, right? R0 means 00. R1 means 01. So here also I have to display that memory, right? So to display the memory, here we have a window, memory window, right? So there are totally 4 memory windows. Any memory window we can use over here, right? So now I want to display these data, right? So this I'll write it as D colon 00H. So D stands for the data memory and 00 is the starting address, right? So memory window will be displayed, right? So starting from 002, I'll go to the last one. So the last one will be around FFH. So now here, I have to identify the address here. So this address is 0. First address is 0. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means so we have a memory location. So this is the memory location. So we have the content over here, n number of locations, right? So in all the location, initial value will be 0. That is, all the location has a value 00 starting from 0 address to this one, FF, right? So this address is 00, so this address is 01, so this address is 02, similarly this address is FF, right? So this address has been displayed over there and even this content has been displayed over there, right? So now here, 30. So this is the starting address. So now I'll take this first row. So first row, there are many memory locations, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, and 23. So there are 23 locations over here. So this has been displayed the starting address over here. Right. And for the remaining location, we have to count and calculate. Suppose if I take this memory location, what is this address? So if this is 0, means this becomes 1. Or this becomes 2, 3, 4, 5. So this location address is 1. Similarly, you can calculate any address of the memory location. Similarly, if I take the second row, starting address is 11. Similarly, third row, starting address is 2E, and we can calculate the remaining address. And this will not be always 0, 17, 2E. So this depends upon the display size. So now if I display the window till here, means, so this changes. That is 0, 12, 24. That means, so this address is 0, this address is 12, this address is 24. Right. So now here we don't have any value because we have not executed the program. So now I have to copy the values into the memory location. Right. So to execute the program, so just go to debug. So here there are different ways of execution. One is run. So that means you can press F5 at a time, the program will be executed. So step. So that is 10. So 10 means, F11 means press F11. So only one line will be executed. That is, we are performing the step by step execution, each instruction by instruction. Right. So always prefer that. So that is press F11. See what happens. Right. So now I'll press F11 once. That means, so now this instruction has been executed. So arrow mark is pointing to the second instruction, that is line number 4. That means this instruction is to be executed next. So now I have executed one instruction. So that is, so before that arrow mark, we have a green color over here. That means it says that that line has been executed. So what is this one? It is move R0, 34. So here we can see the content of the register. R0 is equal to 34 now. So 0x34, it will be displayed as 0x34. That means 34 has been stored into R0, right? Or if I observe this memory window, so D00H, so the first address is 00, so 00 is the address of R0 and that content is 34. Similarly, second one, if I press F11 once again, the second instruction has been executed now. So copy higher byte of first number, move R1, 12H. So 12H is stored into R1. So here also I can observe that. Similarly, move R2, 67. So 67 has been copied to R2. Move R3, F5. So F5 have been copied to R3. Right, so now here while writing this one, 0FY we have written. So now 0 will be discarded. Just it is used to tell the assembler that it is a number. Right. Similarly, now next what I have to do, I have to add this one. So to add the lower byte, first byte we are taken into the accumulator. Right. So move A, R0. So now here A value equal to 30. Similarly, add A, R2. I'll press F11. So now these two has been added. R0 is 34. So 34 plus 67 has been added. Right. So now on adding, what is the result? We have got 34 plus 67. We have got 9B. So where is this 9B now? It is in accumulator. See, it is 9B. So now on this addition, whether we have a carry, we don't have a carry. So carry flag is reset. Right. So now I have to store that result to memory location 40H. So I'll execute that instruction. I'll press F11. So has been stored into 40 height. Right, to view 40 height, this is 36, right, 37, 38, 39, then it is 3A, 3B, 3C, 3D, 3E, 3F, and 40. So at 40 location, we have the result 9B. So now add the higher byte. I'll press F11. So register R1 content is copied to accumulator. So what is R1? It is 12. So 12 has been copied to accumulator. Now add C A comma R3. So what is there in carry flag? It is 0. 0 plus A, that is 12. 12 plus R3. So 12 plus R3 means we have got the result as 7. 0, 7 and with 1 carry. Fine. So now, so 0, 7 is there in accumulator, observe the carry back. This is 1. Fine. So I'm storing that one to 41H. So 41H we have a content 0, 7. But where is 1? 1 is there in your carry flag. So I have to even store this one. Right. So to store this one, first I have to clear the accumulator, because what is there in accumulator? That is 07. So if I directly add C 8,00H means 7 plus 1, 8 will be stored. I don't want 8, I want 1. Right. So first clear the accumulator. So move 8,00H. So accumulator is 0. So then add 0 to accumulator along with the carry. Right. So now carry has become 1, because after this addition A equal to 1, so and there is no carry from this addition, so the carry flag has become 0. Right. So now what is that carry, previous carry 1, and where is that carry? It is an accumulator. Now store that one to a memory location 43H. Now 43H has been stored with carry. Right. So 40, 41. So this should be actually 42. So I've written 43, so it has been stored to the next location. Right. So this is the result. 01, 07, 90. First I have stored the lower byte, then the higher bytes. Right. So the result is 10790. So 1 has been stored over here, 9790. So it requires 3 bytes. So 3 bytes are used over here. 3 locations are used over here. So you can store this one to any location. It's not that always I have to take 40. Even I can start storing from here also. 24, 25, 26 also. Right. It left to the programmer. It left to the you. So you can define any location and you can store that one over there. Right. So I hope you have understood that how to add two 16-bit numbers. Right. So instead of this one, now I want to add two, not 16 bit. So I'll increase the size. This is the 2 byte addition. I want to perform 3 bytes. So now instead of this one, even I can write it as 2 byte addition. Right. So it is 2 byte. 16 bit means 2 byte. Right. So now I don't want to add 16 bit number. I want to add 24 bit number or a 3 byte. So 3 byte means what? You have to store that one into a memory location. So you'll be requiring 3 locations to store one number. Right. So I'll take 3 instructions over here. Right. So now I'll take that number. Instead of this one, I'll be having one more byte over here. So R0, R1, I'll use R2. R3, R4 and R5. Then I'll be performing the first byte addition, second byte addition, third byte addition. Right. So the result size will be 4 bytes now. Right. So you'll be defining 4 locations to store that particular result. Is it clear? So now here, first instruction will be add. For the second byte, it will be add C. For the third byte, it will be add C. And finally, to store the carry, once again, it is add C. Is it clear? So I'll stop it over here. Just try to analyze this program and try to write a program for 3 byte addition or 4 byte or a 5 byte addition. So if you have any doubt, you can message me directly. Okay.